Hey everybody, this is Will and Nate. Welcome to the Mobile Minute from Dropsource. Thanks for joining. Today we want to talk about a relatively new cross-platform framework out there called Flutter. So we've been using Flutter internally, and we'd like to tell you today the three things that we believe set Flutter apart from the pack of all the cross-platform frameworks out there in the market today. Nate, for the benefit of anyone who hasn't heard of it yet, tell us just exactly what is Flutter.
Flutter is Google's new open source UI toolkit for building cross-platform applications. And so Google is certainly not the first company to release a framework of this type. They're really following in the footsteps of Facebook's React Native, Xamarin, which is now owned by Microsoft. And although it's very similar in a lot of its concepts and the way that it works, it's different in a few key components that we think set it apart from the others.
Okay, so it has some differentiators. There are other well-established cross-platform frameworks out there, some that have been around for a while and are widely used. Why do we need another cross-platform framework?
Yeah, I don't think that any solution out there today has really solved the cross-platform problem very well. Namely, a lot of the scalability concerns with React Native and some of the usability issues with Xamarin. And so my three reasons for why Flutter stands out. Number one, the language choice. Flutter has made a really great decision to use the Dart programming language. It's very expressive, it's very dynamic, but also has a lot of the safety of a statically typed language like Swift or Kotlin. Second reason, as a result of choosing Dart, they have a lot of performance benefits that supersede Xamarin React Native. Flutter and Dart is compiled ahead of time, and so you don't have a lot of the same runtime issues that languages like JavaScript have. And so that's been really exciting and really great to see a cross-platform framework perform at the speed and the level that Flutter has. Third is the general Flutter architecture has been really awesome to use so far. From the start, the Flutter team has decided to draw every pixel of the UI themselves. And so unlike a React Native or Xamarin, they don't just wrap the native components, they actually draw all of the components themselves. This has a lot of benefits. You know, there are some concerns from people, but we see this as a positive. It really improves the reusability of your code. Specifically from the UI side, you can use things for iOS and Android a lot more seamlessly. And also, they set themselves up really nicely to be kind of the UI platform of the future. So running on things like mobile, web, desktop, IoT. Google's future operating system called Fuchsia is really going to be based on the concept of Flutter.
So finally achieving the build once, deploy everywhere promise. We have used Flutter internally to build several apps for clients, so we can absolutely vouch for the high level of performance and an amazing developer experience. We're going to be talking quite a bit about Flutter here on this channel in future Mobile Minutes and more, so would love for you to subscribe so you can keep up on Flutter news from the Dropsource team. And again, thank you for joining for the Mobile Minute, and we'll see you next time.